Hey guys, short video today because I'll be flying to Texas in a week to shoot some guns. That's not true. I'll be giving a talk and a workshop there for MSI. They're hosting a creator award, which means awesome prizes that you can win at the event. But they're also hosting an online event, meaning that everyone can participate. You can click the first link in the description down below for more information. Yeah, let's just pause right here. Guys, we were just about to upload the video. And I have just received an email from MSI. Very unfortunate, but they had to cancel the MSI Creator Awards at South by Southwest, the event that I was going to, because of the coronavirus. A lot of companies are pulling back from the event out of safety, of course. So I don't blame anyone for this. It's good that they make this decision. So that means that event is not ongoing anymore. However, the online event is still going further, so you can still sign up and participate in the online creator awards from MSI and win some amazing prizes. So definitely make sure to click that first link in the description. All right, back to you, Jordy. Now, recently I came across a creator called Cash Bunny on Instagram. Now, for some reason, I did not know about her work before, which is a pity because it's quite amazing. Now, basically, she makes these short videos with a ton of visual effects in them. But they aren't just general effects. Every time she does something very original and creative, like some of the examples that you're seeing right here. Now, I was very amazed when I saw her work, and I'm gonna leave a link to her Instagram in the description down below. Also, definitely check it out. Now, in one of her videos, you can see these rotating shoes, which was cleverly done by simply putting some shoes on a rotating disc, which you can key out and then place on a 360 background that she also shot, as you can see right here. Very creative, and I wanted to build a little bit further on that idea and make a stop motion with time remapping. So, just like she did, we started out by creating a rotating disc. We had a spinning wheel laying around and we bolted that to a plank. You want to make sure that the disc is not able to wiggle. Now, we also added some L irons on the sides just to make sure that it stays in place. On there, place a green screen, and I would recommend getting some green paper as you can more easily cut it out. Because of shadow issues, we decided to levitate every object on the disc, which will make the keying go easier. And now it's just a matter of rotating the disc a tiny bit. Take a photo with your camera on a tripod, rotate it again, picture, rotate, picture, etc. Now here are a few things that you need to pay attention to. First of all, you want to avoid touching your camera, as that could add shake to the final result. So either use a remote, which you can buy as an accessory, or connect your camera to a laptop and download a dedicated software from your camera brands, which allows you to snap pictures from there. And most of the time, you'll also have a stop motion feature that overlays the picture that you previously took, making it easier to align your next step. Now, ideally, you want to add some sort of marks on the disc so that your rotations are equal. Now, since we're using a spinning wheel, it already had these spins on it, but we added some extra marks to it as well. Just to be sure that we would end up with 240 frames for a full rotation. Now, my idea is to create a speed ramp. And there are two approaches. Either you start with a bigger rotation, and then slowly you create smaller steps, which probably saves you time, but you won't be able to change any of your time remapping in post-production. So, what we did was just make very tiny steps and shoot a ton of pictures. It's best to practice first, like record 30 pictures and then check it out. Maybe you're overlooking something that you can adjust before you start taking hundreds of photos. Alright, so when you have all of your pictures, import them into Premiere Pro. And make sure that your still image duration is set to 1 frame for super smooth playback, or 2 frames if you prefer that stop motion look. You can now drag all of your pictures into a timeline, which has a higher frame rate, such as 120 or so, that we can speed ramp it later on. Then right click on everything and choose Nest to group them together. Then from the opacity, take the pen tool to mask around the camera, and when you're done with that, apply the ultra key effect to select and remove the green. Next up, we're going to get a 360 or VR background. You can make this yourself using a 360 camera like the one from Insta360, or you can download a stock clip from Storyblocks, who also have tons of VR clips, which is what I'm gonna do right now. Then place this clip underneath your stop motion. What I then wanna do is apply the effect called GoPro Reframe to it. It's a third-party plugin, but it's free, so you can download it from the GoPro website. I'll leave a link to it as well in the description below. And this effect allows you to animate the jaw property, making the VR clip pan around. Animate it in such a way that it matches the speed of your stop motion. I'm also going to add a directional blur to the background to reassemble the motion blur. Now let's go ahead and create a new sequence, but this time with a normal 24 or 30 FPS. In here, drag the sequence of your stop motion, which gives you a clip of 120 FPS, meaning that we can now slow it down 5 times, creating a beautiful time remapping anywhere in the clip that we want. And here is the final result of that. Yeah, hey, it's future Jordy here. We had a different ending to this video, so I also had to re-record this part. Normally I would talk about South by Southwest, but since I'm not going there anymore now, here's a different ending. So you can still participate in the online MSI Creator Awards by clicking that first link in the description down below. What you just have to do is make a creative video that includes the MSI logo, for example, just like we did with the stop motion. Or if that doesn't give you inspiration, then definitely check out Cash Bunny, because she will definitely fill up your creativity. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, MSI, for the support. We will definitely collaborate more in the future. Until then, stay creative.
Jordy, this is way too much work.
You just kicked a tripod. You're making it a lot of work yourself, Lorenzo. You just kicked a tripod.